this is one of your New Year's resolutions, don't forget about your pet. Charlotte Reed, back, our pet expert, with some more ideas. Thank you for coming.
Thanks for having me. You know, this is go month, and I'm so excited because I have all of these dogs, cats, and birds, and my house on a daily basis looks like an explosion hit it. So we're going to start from this side of the room and work our way down.
Okay.
So first up, I love to tell people, store their grooming supplies. These are all these Furminator toys before. Shower Caddy, $5.99, the container store.
Great.
Love it. Pottery Barn leash holder. How great is that?
That is so cool.
It's beautiful. You hang it on the back of the door. You always hang it in a place where you leave with your dog the most.
Right. So you can always grab it. You can put it somewhere that's sturdy and you can add some stuff to it.
No problem. What to do with dog coats and sweaters. Mm-hmm. You hang coats, okay? And sweaters you put in this great little box. And these are by Baxter Boo, the hangers.
Of course.
And these are by Lazy Bones.
Awesome.
Okay, toys. I love this Martha Stewart caddy. It's $9.99 on sale from PetSmart. So what's great about it is you go around the house like a caddy.
And you pick them
up. And you pick them up and throw them in there.
Sure.
Exactly. Next up, one of the things that APAW, the Advocacy for Affordable Health, Advocacy for Pets and Affordable Wellness always tells us it's important to be cognizant of where we store our medication.
Okay.
So we have different options.
Yeah, because pets are on a lot of meds.
Exactly. Some pets are. We have lockable boxes, so children can't get in them. If you have more than one pet, I like these stackables to store the medicine. These are both from the container store. Also,
nice.
I got these particular products, Sistema products, from Storables online website. And what's nice about it is you can store, like, the various VetGuard or VetID pet meds.
Right.
Okay. Also, you have food containers. Mm-hmm. So some people like to do the frozen and the raw diets. You make them, you put them up in these containers here.
Stick them right in.
Now, you were just talking about your big problem, finding the dog and cat food in the refrigerator.
Yeah, and we always use the tinfoil to cover the lid.
Exactly. Bad. Mm-hmm. Because the air gets to the food.
Bacteria.
And it's spoils faster. Mm-hmm. So what you want to do is you want to use these bright colored pet food
these are great.
Cover
I'm
going lids.
To tilt these up so that you can see them.
Sure.
These are absolutely awesome. They're adorable. And where can you find these?
I love those. They're at the container store and they're $2.95. Other mistake
so
that
cute.
People always make is what to do with your pet food.
Yeah.
So this is a Simply Human food storage can.
It looks like a trash can.
It does. But what I love about it is there's a scoop right here in the top.
Nice.
The most important thing I want people to recognize is that when you store your food, keep the food in the bag.
Okay.
You keep the food in the bag.
Okay. And you keep it in, thank you, and you stick it right in there.
Exactly.
Okay.
And that's by Simple Human. And it's very nice. It's and they also have a plastic one. So if you can't go for the stainless steel, which is a little pricey, over $100, you can go for the $59.99. plastic trash can.
I'm just loving the Simple Human phrase, though, right? You Simple Human, right?
Simple Human.
Okay.
We love
Rona's
it.
Rona's right here. Lisa has been standing by looking at her favorite dog, and she has washed the hair away, so she's feeling just fine right now. There you go, Rona. Doing great. You can find more information on all of these products on Charlotte's website, charlottereed.com. The time right now, 7:20.